So it turns out that my miter sled is coming up a little bit short when it's coming to cross cut these really long pieces. And since I don't have an extension arm that heads way out to as long as I need it, I came up with a neat little trick today to help me get accurate cuts. And I'm going to show it to you on this Matt's Basement Workshop short.
Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Sponsored by SawStop, North America's number one cabinet saw. For more information, visit sawstop.com by Lee Valley and Veritas. With over 5,000 high-quality woodworking hand tools, visit their online catalog at leevalley.com.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. So I'm going to show you this neat little trick that I just discovered myself. In fact, I want to take all the credit for this, but chances are I probably saw this someplace and subconsciously it popped up just when I needed it. As of right now, I've been milling up all of the pieces for the undercarriage for Aiden's platform bed. And one problem I'm running into is I have some rather long pieces that I need to cross cut. Now, I could take this over to the miter saw and do something like that, but I really like the accuracy I get off of my miter sled here. But the only problem is the longest pieces, in fact, the ones back in there, are 72 inches. And obviously, you can see simply because this piece here is just over 53 inches and we need to cut it down to 52, it's hanging off the miter sled here. Now, rather than creating some sort of long extension arm and having that flopping all over the place and putting a stop block on it, I'm going to show you this neat little technique that I discovered, and it worked out really great. In fact, I've been getting really super accurate results. I'm kind of amazed that it's actually happening. So let's go ahead, come right in here. I'm going to put my safety gear on, and the first thing I'm going to do is make my very first cut. But before I do that, you notice I've got this clamped in place, and I'm going to show you why I have it clamped in place. It's going to stay clamped in place after I make that first cut. So let me go ahead and make that cut, and then we'll come right back in, and I'll show you what we're going to do next. Okay, so we've made the first cut. We leave it clamped in position, and we only need to do this once, actually. I am now going to, this cut edge here is still registering right exactly where the blade was. So I mark over approximately, well, exactly 1 inch. So I'm gonna mark that on the fence itself, and we'll get a close up. You can see that it's in position there. And then now what I'm gonna end up doing is I want this piece to be exactly 52 inches. So I'm gonna flip it end for end so that the same face is gonna register, or the edge is gonna register up against the fence here. And I know that this mark is 1 inch over exactly from where that cut's gonna be. So if I want this 52 inches, I'm now gonna measure from that freshly cut end. I'm gonna measure 51 inches. So that's one less than what I need. So let's go ahead and get our mark on here. And then I am now going to take that mark and I'm going to register it right up against that mark that we made on the fence itself, just to be on the safe side. We'll clamp this in position, put on the safety gear, make our cut, and then we're going to measure it. All right, so let's go ahead and take this off, and we're now going to measure it. It should be exactly 52 inches. And it is. It's exactly, perfectly 52 inches. I'm still amazed that it comes out accurate every single time, but it's a really simple trick. And the main thing is, of course, to keep everything clamped in position with that first cut. Make that reference. Make it something that's really easy. It doesn't have to be an inch. It could be 2, 3, 4, even half an inch or something. Just make sure that you subtract it from the total length that you actually need, and you're always going to get it. And the nice thing about this is you don't have to come up with some elaborate system here on the back end to take care of it. In fact, I am positive if you have a really solid miter gauge, you could do the same exact thing if you have a nice sacrificial fence that's going to hold everything in place. So I hope that this really helps out. Again, it was really nice to find this great trick without having to come up with some elaborate little scheme. If you have any comments, questions, suggestions, I'd love to hear them. mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com is how you can get a hold of me by email. You can leave a comment in today's show notes over at mattsbasementworkshop.com. And if you're watching this at YouTube, I'd love to hear from you over there. So until we actually have time to get a little bit more done here on Aiden's platform bed and get the first video up, which will be the construction of the undercarriage, which we've got a little bit more to do. As soon as I finish taking care of these rough dimensionings, we'll get right along with that. So I hope to talk to you very soon. So until the next time, straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.
Thanks for watching. To find even more videos and woodworking related content, be sure to visit our website at mattsbasementworkshop.com. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. And don't forget to subscribe to the show either on YouTube, in iTunes, or you can even receive email notifications whenever we post something new.